Hi, I'm here today to show you how to break in your new glove, okay? Your new glove that you just purchased with a microwave oven. Best way to break in any new glove is with heat, okay? And I have three ways on how to do it. One, it's the easiest anybody can do. Use your car. Wrap this in with your, after you oil it up or you gel it up, depending on what kind of lubricants. Put your balls in the proper position for certain gloves. Talk about that later as well. Wrap it up. Want to be using an ace bandage. Don't want to be using any twine or anything like that, because you'll leave marks on your glove and that's not going to look pretty. Wrap it up in a black plastic bag. Put it in your windshield while you're at work or while your car's in the driveway and whatnot. That's one of the easiest ways to do it. You don't have to worry about anything. You can leave it there all day long. The bag's gonna heat up hot enough to get this leather nice and toasty. If you need to use this glove within 3 days, I'm gonna show you how to do it. That's one. The second way to do it is obviously using the conventional oven. And I used that before I started using microwaves. Very easy, you know, to use as well. Don't be afraid of it. You can go online as well. YouTube has a few people using conventional ovens. It's a good way to use it. What you do is you go ahead and heat up your oven at 200 degrees. Okay, it's not very hot. It's not going to burn anything. 200 degrees. Then turn it off. We just want to use the heat. We don't want to cook your glove. Turn it off. Get a cookie sheet. Place this on your cookie sheet. Slip it in there and just leave it in there for no more than 3 to 5 minutes, you know, till the glove gets nice and warm. Now, when you use a conventional oven, you won't be placing the balls in here. You're gonna just be leaving it, after you oil it, you're gonna leave it just like this, right on top of the, you know, your little cookie sheet. Slip it in there and leave it in there, like I said, for 3 to 5 minutes. It's gonna heat up, it's gonna be nice and soft. You're gonna grab your ball and you're gonna place it in there. This is the first basement glove. This one's gonna use two balls. We're gonna be putting it in here like this in conventional. We're gonna be wrapping it with an ace bandage. Like I told you, if you use string or twiner, you will leave marks on your leather. You don't wanna do that. You wanna use an ace bandage. Plus the ace bandage you can use over and over. Okay, that's the second way. The third way, and my favorite way, is using the microwave. Okay, this is what we're gonna do. Couple things you're gonna need to use the microwave. First, new glove. The only reason why we're doing it is because we have a new glove. Second, you wanna have a plastic bag. I like a nice, it's a heavier bag. It's a white plastic trash bag. If you don't have this, don't worry. You can use two of your supermarket plastic bags. Those work just fine because you're gonna be putting a knot. Why are we using plastic? We don't want any of this moisture to get away from here. We're not trying to dry out the glove, we're just trying to heat it up. Okay, so you can use this bag. Like I said earlier, if you're using a bag outside, you want to use a black bag for the outside on your windshield. Why? Because the black bag will, you know, suck in the heat and heat up the glove the way you want it. Plastic bag, we're gonna need ace bandage. I already told you why we need that. We don't want to use twine, leave marks on the gloves. We're gonna use a ball or two ball, depending on what kind of glove you have. You're breaking in a middle infielder glove, you wanna concentrate only on the pocket, the center pocket. This is a first baseman glove, so we're gonna do pocket and webbing. And we wanna use your favorite lubricant. I like Vaseline. We'll talk about lubricants at the end that I've used and that you have on your home. Okay, first thing we want to do is want to oil down the inside of the glove. Don't forget, you want to get the creasing right here. Very important to get this creasing as well. Let me zoom right here, right where the glove bends, right here, this little area right here. This is where I want you to concentrate on your heavy lubricant. I'll tell you a funny story about this glove at the end of this video. Okay, so now the next thing we want to do, after we've already lubricated the inside, very important, I need you to lubricate all these laces. Okay, very important laces. The laces are the easiest thing that'll get brittle pretty quick. So after this is all oil set to go, get your balls, put them in here. Go ahead, get your ace bandage, wrap it up. And you're gonna be wrapping up gloves differently because this is the first baseman glove, so we're wrapping it up like this with the crease on here. Middle infielder glove, we wrap it up different. I'll show you those in another video. Here, so now we have this wrapped up because we need the heat. We're gonna create memory on this. Now, we're gonna put it in this bag. And what I wanna do is I wanna make a knot. I don't want any of this moisture escaping, okay? I'm not trying to dry out the glove. I'm trying to heat up the leather, okay? So now the next thing I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna pop it into my microwave for 2 minutes. I'm gonna check it. I'm gonna touch the bag. If it's warm, it's not hot enough. I'll put it in for another 2 minutes. As soon as the bag starts to get pretty hot, then you're good. Stop. Don't touch it. Let it cool off for, I'd say, at least an hour. Why I suggest you get a baseball mallet is that it's much better than a playing catch with a friend. The mallet, it's called a baseball mallet. Go on online. You can purchase it online. They range anywhere from $20 to $35. They're made out of wood. You can go on YouTube. A guy on there showed us how to make a baseball mallet from a baseball, believe it or not. Shows you how to drill out the hole using the end of a paint roller, epoxy glue, putting it together. And there you go, you have your homemade baseball mallet. Again, you can do it that way. He said it was under $6. I'd go that route if you have the time to do it. If you don't, go to your sporting goods store and buy your mallet there. The mallet is the key thing. That's what's gonna get your glove working in 3 days. So now that it's nice and warm, it's gonna be soft, you're gonna just beat on this glove. Just beat it, beat it. You're not gonna hurt it because it's a round piece of wood or baseball, which you play with it anyway. All you have to do is work this glove in with that for, I'd say 20 minutes a day. 20 minutes a day. Put this in there, wrap it up, keep it in there. You don't have to keep putting it in the microwave, okay? Once you've done this the first time, you're good. Just remember to keep this glove. If you want to, keep it in your car with you. That's a great idea. Always remember, keep a ball in there and keep it wrapped up with this. Again, that's the special way that I love doing it with the microwave. And I think we're done. Okay, about that, funny story I promised you about the glove. Well, my friend bought this glove for his son. I tried to explain to him how to go ahead and use the microwave. Obviously, he didn't follow my directions. He put it in there. Whether he didn't close the bag or not, I don't know what he did. What he ended up doing was he ended up using too much heat. What the heat did, it just dried out all the laces. It just instantly just turned to brittle. And when he opened the microwave, the whole glove fell apart. He went to pick it up, and everything had fallen apart that the laces were holding on to. He cracked me up. I took pictures of it, and if I remember, I'll go ahead and put them on here so you could see the glove all in pieces. But it didn't hurt the leather or anything like that. Just the laces, you know, were damaged. As you can see, it's all relaced. If this video helped you, please leave comments. Leave video comments as well. Rate my video. And I hope I've helped you. And I'll have the other videos coming soon.